Daniel Crosslink, welcome back to the channel. Today we're installing the BLTouch bed leveling probe on the Ender 3 V2. This BLTouch upgrade is going to work with both the 4.2.2 or 4.2.7 mainboard that you might also find in this Ender model. It's just going to be a minor difference in the firmware selection. You'll see that later. As every time, you'll be able to jump to the section of your interest using the video chapters. And now let's get started with some words about why you probably want to do this modification to your printer. The Ender 3 V2 usually is a pretty reliable printer in terms of print quality, and you'll also find it not too difficult to get the first print layer down to the glass bed. However, there is multiple factors that account for your success in getting a nice first layer printed, and one is how flat the underlying surface is. The glass plate that comes with this printer model is usually quite flat, but if there happens to be a slight difference between the corners of the printer area and the center, then you might want to compensate those differences for a perfect result. Solutions for this issue are either using mesh bed leveling or the more advanced unified bed leveling if you don't want to invest in a leveling probe. However, both methods bring along a lot more time investment to tune in the right distance in every measured position, and swapping out the print surface because you like to print a different kind of material or need a different kind of adhesive will make you redo the whole mesh bed leveling. That's why using a probe is the better solution in my opinion, resulting in a much faster and way better automated process. It's also going to be more consistent with different kinds of surface types. And if you're going for a removable magnetic build plate, which I really like, it makes even more sense as this won't be in the exact same position every time you take it off and put it back on. The BLTouch uses a deployable pin to measure a point of contact in the bed leveling process. Depending whether you buy the original BLTouch, which costs around $35 to $40, or a clone version like the 3D Touch or similar ones, which cost around $20, this might be a more or less expensive upgrade. All of them will give you reasonable quality results. Both options, along with some accessories that we also show in this video, are linked in the description of this video. Today we're using the original Creality BLTouch kit for the Ender 3 V2, which comes with the corresponding holding bracket and the right cable for the Creality 4.2.x mainboard, which makes installation even more convenient. I've linked that kit also in the description of this video. But still, if you're getting the standalone version of the BLTouch, a pair of cheap servo extension cables and some Dupont connectors will do the job equally well. You just have to double check that the pin assignment from the BLTouch or 3D Touch corresponds to the mainboard pinout. We'll talk about custom wiring a bit later in the video. So the first thing to do with the sensor is to mount it to the mounting bracket for your printer model. In the Creality kit, you'll find a specific version for the Ender 3 V2. If you have ordered the BLTouch or a clone as a standalone version, you'll first need to print a specific bracket for your Ender model, which I've done here for the Ender 3 Pro, just as an example. However, in general, I can recommend going for the kit because the metal brackets are just more reliable and gonna keep their external dimensions even if there's a lot of heat coming from the printer. So I'm gonna mount the BLTouch sensor to the bracket with the corresponding screws. I'm using the shorter ones, the M3x6mm. Now on the backside of the BLTouch, I connect the small connector of the connection cable to the BLTouch backside block, very carefully pushing that in until it locks in place. Then I bring the holder in position, and normally on the Ender 3 V2, there's going to be two screw holes that perfectly align with the bracket, drill holes, and you can just use the other two screws to fix the bracket. However, in my case, and maybe for a few of you, this might be the same. Creality somehow forgot to drill these two holes, probably because it's a very early version of the Ender 3 V2. So instead of fixing the bracket with screws, I'm going to glue the holder to the carriage, and to find the right distance of the probe to the print bed, I'm using a little helper tool. Actually, that is the one I'm always using when I do a custom BLTouch mount. You can just print this out and it's going to be inserted between the bed and the sensor, and your printer nozzle should be just touching the build plate at the same time. This is going to be your reference. So since this bracket is now fixed, let's do the cable connection to the mainboard. First, I would fix that sensor cable just using a few zip ties along the existing cable wrap that goes down to the mainboard. That's just a little cleaner than just having it dangling around. I'm opening the electronics box by releasing the screw at the top and at the bottom of the printer that hold the case cover in place. And once it's open, the first thing to do is to note the mainboard version. By the time this video was recorded, this can either be 4.2.2 or 4.2.7. I'll need that later for selecting the proper firmware for the mainboard. So cable connection to the mainboard is really simple with the Creality kit. The plug fits perfectly to the socket on the mainboard, and that is everything that you have to do. However, if you're using a custom cable like a server extension, you will have to double check that the pins going out from the sensor are going into the right pins on the mainboard. Don't look at the cable colors because these might be completely different. So to make it clear, I've linked the Creality mainboard pin layout so you can check on the back of your sensor to find the right pins and do the custom wiring. So you see, there is good reasons to use the BLTouch kit because that makes it so much simpler, and I really highly recommend to use it. There's one thing left, disconnecting the original set-stop cable from the mainboard because we don't need it anymore. Just put this in a place where it doesn't obstruct anything else. Next, I'm opening the electronics case even further by removing the two big screws that hold the case fixed to the frame. And then I'm pulling carefully the sensor cable through the gap, so at the end I can have it exit the case here at the corner where the other cables also exit to the top. Now I'm fixing everything back in place, the front screws, the bottom case screws, and finally the top screw of the case. And here's why I wanted the cable to come out to the top of the case, because we have this little gap here where the cable fits through just fine, and then we can route it to the left where it goes to the sensor along the cable wrap. Final thing to do here in terms of the hardware installation is to unplug and remove the old set and stop switch, which is now obsolete. What's left now is to install a new firmware version that supports the BLTouch sensor. I'm taking the one from the Creality homepage by going to the support and download section. Here I look for my printer model, the Ender 3 V2, and I also need to select the right mainboard version. So in my case, it's 4.2.2, and in your case, it might also be 4.2.7. That's why I said check your mainboard version because it matters. Now this page might be looking different from what you've seen in other videos because Creality has changed how they package up the firmware. There's just one file per mainboard version now, no individual downloads for BLTouch anymore. So after unpacking that file on my computer, I have different folders for different setups. The one that we are looking for is BLTouch non-adapter board firmware. The other one is not relevant for us. So I'm taking that firmware bin file and copy that to the SD card. And I'm also deleting any previous bin file that might have existed from previous firmware installations. Please don't forget about this. Then I'm inserting the SD card into the printer. Once I've turned off the power and turned it back on, the printer will install the new firmware. Also, the BLTouch sensor should turn red and do its little up and down dance. If it doesn't finish with the pin retracted, or if it's blinking, something about the wiring might be wrong or the firmware might be incorrect. So in that case, double check everything before you continue. On the printer main menu, there will be a new item called level. I'm selecting that item and the printer will start doing a bed leveling in 9 points of the print area. After that's done, I'm going to select the prepare menu and then auto home. The sensor is going to measure the distance in the middle of the bed and then stop at the higher position. Now I'm bringing down the nozzle to the actual zero position by selecting the move menu and then the move Z item. I'm turning the knob until it says 0.0 and then I confirm. The nozzle is now down at the zero position, but still probably 2-3 millimeters away from the print surface. So what I need to do now is to set an initial Z offset to start with. So I'm going back to the prepare menu, and then I'm selecting the Z offset item and set it to -3.0. Another time I'm going to select auto home, and I'm bringing the nozzle down to about 2 millimeters just to start with using the move Z menu. Now, while inserting and moving a piece of paper in between the nozzle and the print bed, I'm bringing the nozzle down in 0.1 millimeter increments. You have to confirm a new value every time you change it. So the distance I found to be good in my case is 1.3 millimeter, and that's going to be our correction value for the Z offset. So you remember I set it to -3.0. Now I am adding the new offset of 1.3 millimeter, and so I will change it to -1.7 and confirm the new value. So again, if you repeat the auto home now and bring the nozzle back to 0.0, it should be at the desired distance. And if not, you need to change that value accordingly. A more negative Z offset value brings the nozzle closer to the surface, whereas with a less negative Z offset, the nozzle will be further away from the surface when it's coming down to 0.0. Finally, I'm saving my settings using the control menu and then selecting the storage configuration item. That makes sure my current Z offset is saved to the printer, otherwise it will be lost as soon as I power off the printer. To use auto bed leveling in your prints going forward, you will have to modify the startup code for your printer that's being generated by your slicer software. In my case, that's going to be CURA. In CURA, I'm selecting my printer from the drop-down menu, then I click Manage Printers. Then I go to the Machine Settings. And here in the Start GCODE panel, I look for the G28 command. Here it is. I'm adding a new line right after G28, which will be the G29 command for auto bed leveling. Then I can close these dialogues. What I'm doing is a final confirmation of my settings is to start a test print so I can see whether I have the right distance and the right amount of squeeze of filament to the print surface. And if I see that it's not ideal, I can tweak it during the print using the tune menu of the printer. That's my video about the BLTouch installation on the Ender 3 V2. If you liked it, you might also consider watching one of the other two I've linked up here for you, and I see you in the next one. Bye!